Well, curmudgeon welcomes you to Bleak Falls Barrel. I'm here at the request of two people. Actually, one, well, three. No, two, I guess, just Farangar in Whiterun and Lucius, the, or Lucan. Lucan, I guess, the shopkeeper. In Riverwood. Back to sleep, my lovelies, back to sleep. Everybody back to sleep. Take the soul gem, take the garnet, take the gold. I don't want hide boots and I don't want an elven. Well, no, actually I will take the, I'll take the hide boots too. I don't think I've ever been through one of these places in which I, at least not at a low level, I've come through here. Legendary. I was doing single-handed, you know, but it was because I was I'd already run archery all the way to 100, and I was. Finished the main quest line and had been sent back through here on a radiant quest or something. Get a book or something. Because you can get sent through here on a radiant quest. Book quest. It's something of a shock when you get it, but you can get sent through here. Anyway, what I was thinking was I would really not like to come through here. I think I have a vague memory of when I first played the game my very first time, and I played it up and up, and I played it the way they want you to play it, you know, and they guide you, and they channel you here. I remember coming through here and just being terrified. And, you know, wondering how in the world I was supposed to survive, because I didn't survive. Then I'm not a very good game player. I mean, I'm not good at this. I'm not good at all. I just have worked out a way to play the game that works for me. I mean, you'll notice a lot of things that I don't do. For example, I don't use potions. I don't really understand the whole potion thing. You know, the whole idea of stopping in the middle of that. Well, I mean, I don't really get in any big fights, as you'll notice. I don't believe in big fights. Sort of one of the basic tenet of combat. You know, if you wind up in close combat, I mean really close combat with the enemy, something has gone terribly wrong. Might have been a day long ago when you wanted to get up close and personal with your enemy, but no longer. You know. In fact, that was one of the things in Vietnam that Charlie desperately wanted to do, in fact. That was his main tactic, in fact, was to get as close as possible. Because he firmly believed that if he could get close enough, right up, hand to hand, basically, as far as he was concerned, then he could even the odds. And he could basically win if he could get right up close. Because then, as far as he was concerned, in his thinking, he would negate our firepower. Our firepower with artillery and air power, and make it his troops against our troops. Now, it didn't work for him. I mean, he had the idea that his troops against our troops, he would always win. He was mistaken. people have made the mistake of thinking that our troops were they look at our society and it's easy enough to understand. We have a pretty decadent society. So it's easy enough to see how they would think that our military might reflect our society. And to some degree it does. The peacetime military does. I mean, I can attest to that. I was in both the wartime Marine Corps and peacetime Marine Corps, and there's a difference. Fortunately, things change in a war zone, and a lot of the peacetime bull gets jettisoned. In war, as you learn that things that okay, what do we got here? We have a bear, a moth, and an owl. Bear, moth, owl. It's quite a place, isn't it? Just sort of nasty, dirty, grimy looking place. Must be the thing that Farangar wants. Yep. Ooh, Amulet of Zenithar. Prices are 10% better. Very cool. Thank you, Arbok.
The sooner you're back from Bleak Falls. Did you find anything?
I have the claw.
You found it? There it is! Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh? I'm gonna put this back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
It means so much to us.
Thank you so much for taking a bit of this and a bit of that.
It's a fine day.
May the gods, the finest weapons and armor.
Feels good, but take a look.
And iron ingots and ore. And
see me at my forge if you need arms or armor.
See anything you like. Well met. Some may call this junk. Me, I call them treasures.
Lockpicks. I have enough straw, I'm pretty sure.
Steal anything from my shop and you'll regret it.
All right, let's go home and put stuff away. Okay, and I'll put some gems in there that don't belong in there. I'm gonna wait here and figure out what I want to do next time.